Happy Thirsty Thursday. How are you? Not only is it Thirsty Thursday, but it's tea time. Tea time. Tea time for two. Ooh, that's hot. Hot tea. And I've got my love mug. It's all about the love. Spreading the love and the hugs. So, on this Thirsty Thursday, as I'm drinking and sipping upon my tea, I've actually been in very reflective mode this morning. I had my first conference call for the Beyond Addiction program that I'm going through right now, and it's one of the reasons I created a poll about whether or not you have an addiction, if you're open to sharing what that may be, because most of the times we don't even realize that our everyday routines can be our addictions, our attachments to the way we want things to be, how they should be. Well, it's just meant to be that way. It's supposed to be that way, right? So here's the thing. It can't be fixed until it's spoken. Ooh, that's profound. It can't be fixed until it's spoken. Meaning, the moment you mouth the words that something is awry, it's off, something's not right, that is the opportunity, and that's when the momentum grows into fixing, right? So, again, shift happens. It's happening all the time. Change is constant. Constantly happening, naked eye can't even see it. Change is like death. At the same time, whenever you go through a shift and a change in your life, you have to recognize emotions will come up to surface, because that's opportunity to recognize there was an old attachment to the familiar. Those routines, those habits, those behaviors that you may have that you are now having to adjust to and reach outside of yourself, inside, right? Because technically we think our outside is our inside. You have to go within and recognize, oh my gosh, be the witness, observe, breathe in fully all that's happening in your life, and understand that the change has always been happening. It's just that now you're visually seeing it and that you're actually feeling like you're going through it, but it had been happening all along. And so, like I said, change is like death, and we all go through a mourning period. An adjustment. It's time to recognize that, oh, things are not going to be the way they have been. And it's that adjustment, that mourning, and recognizing that things are changing, they have happened, and now it's time to adapt. And how adaptable are you? Most people are not adaptable to the changes that are occurring in their lives. They're more wanting to stay in their comfort zones. It's cush, it's happy, it's comfortable in this mode, this way. And then when you have to reach outside of yourself and see what's going on, right? See what's really bubbling up to surface, so you have that opportunity to heal. So you have to feel it fully to heal it fully. And that sometimes means sitting with those most uncomfortable sensations of emotions. Oh, this doesn't feel good. Anxiety, patience, panic attacks come up. So because most of us don't even have patience, we rarely stop to think, okay, let me step back a moment. Let me breathe into the moment. Because we want things instantaneous, right? Instant gratification. I want it now. I want it done this way. I'm used to it happening this way. I want this to be the way I've always known it. And when it isn't, that's because you're meant to be ruffled, right? Your feathers need to be ruffled for you to recognize you've been in a pattern, a holding pattern. So sometimes that holding pattern is also forcing you to adapt and grow, to evolve mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. And it all starts with self. And again, you know, what's going to be the indicator, the litmus test, is if you have the patience to sit with it, the patience to be with it, the patience to take a moment and give yourself that prana, that breath of life, that life force, that energy, that nurturing, sustaining, maintaining. Because the ultimate is that most of us, when we get in those modes of anxiety, frustration, panic, we're wanting to outwardly attack. We'll actually project it upon another person. We don't even recognize what's going on within ourselves because we just assume that it's all coming from outside of us, which is a reflection of what's going on inside of us. Very true. And so when those moments arise where you feel dis-ease, discomfort, anxiety, anything that brings up those emotions, those are the moments you need to sit with them the most. Those are the moments you need to breathe, because quite often you're going to find you're holding your breath. At the same time you think you're going through this, you're usually fight or flight. You're tightening up the sensations in your body. It's all a reflection of what's going on within, in the mind, and then translated through the body. And so again, prana, baby, breathe that life force. Bring it back to the breath. You can't live without it. And you can't live without change. Change is ever evolving. It is meant, because energy stays in motion. Energy is meant to stay in motion. Emotion, energy in motion. Most of us are having, you know, a lot of life changes going on. And you have to recognize, sit with it in the calm. Sit with it within. You have to confront and you have to be with it. It's the only way you're going to evolve and grow. And when you try to push it away or suppress it, all that's going to do is make it come up stronger, and it'll come up more painful, and it'll continue to dictate your experiences in your life, as well as sometimes it will be the master of what is going on and create more chaos, more dis-ease. It will hurt and ruin relationships with others, because it's the relationship with you that matters most. And if your relationship with yourself is no good, it's just going to be projected upon every other relationship you encounter, every person you come into contact with. It doesn't take much to gain a smile from another person, but the first smile you should be working on is first thing in the morning, is looking in the mirror. Can you smile back at yourself and really embrace all that you are? The love, the being, the you be you, right? All hurts, pains, desires, wishes, great experiences or not. All of those are just categories and labels to keep things in tidy spots. Our biggest addiction, most of us, is to our belief systems, our habits, our routines, our behaviors, because that was preconditioned and we think it's something stable, but it isn't. The only stability is that you are, and you're always going to evolve and change. So again, this illusion is in the mind, because you have no control over anything. Even when you think you do, you don't. And the moment you drop the attachment to having to have everything so perfect and in its tidy little neat organized space, your life will evolve with a lot more ease and grace. And we don't come to that overnight. I haven't, and I still deal with it, and I still have my moments. Because for me, if I want to make someone feel comfortable, I'll overdo. I'll try to overdo and maybe do it everything. And that doesn't always serve me well. And sometimes that takes away from my own personal self-care. And when that happens, those are the moments it's meant for you to go, oh, there you went again. Did you learn your lesson? Because it's cumulative and everything accumulates with moment-to-moment momentum, that if you just bring it back to the patience with self, you'll have be able to extend it to others, right? And you go within so you don't go without. Because life is ever-changing, ever-evolving, and so are you. You're a spiritual being living in a human body. And we're meant to have all of these emotions, all these experiences, because that's what we agreed upon. but we didn't necessarily agree that we would make it so easy or so hard. We just kind of like, we were thrown out into the mouse maze, let's say, you know? The mice, they cheat, they go through the maze looking for the cheese, and we're trying to find our way back to where the cheese is, right? So we're meant to embrace it, the journey, and you can make it joyful even in the hard times. So, you know, you can work on yourself, you can do all of these self-help trainings, workshops, read books, you can watch seminars, you can watch on YouTube, you can do all of this stuff. But the big question is, how do you apply it? How do you integrate it? How adaptable are you? Are you able to adjust and integrate into your life all of the wisdom, the knowledge technically, because ultimately wisdom is the accumulation of all the knowledge when you've integrated it into your physical body, mind, body, soul connection. It's all encompassing. Nobody's just wise. Nobody just has knowledge. But when the two come together, you know, you can be as intelligent as all get out, but the question is, how do you apply the intelligence? And is it human intelligence? Is it from your essence intelligence? Is it intuition into me? I see intimacy. Or is it the kind that's just surface? You know, I can read a book, but that doesn't mean I know how to apply it into my life. And so you can do all the work, but the real work is in living this life and actually embracing it and adapting and constantly being open to change. Because again, to the naked eye, you cannot see all of the changes that are occurring in your life. And the changes that become so profound in the moment that you finally do recognize them have always been set in motion. They've always been happening. It's just that you didn't see it right away, right? It's like when you look in the mirror and you go, oh my gosh, I have a little wrinkle. Oh my gosh, you know, my eyebrows are not as dark as they once were, as full. Or maybe I have a little silver, right? It didn't just happen overnight. It's just that you couldn't put your full attention and focus on just the one aspect because you see the whole overall. And there's so many smaller parts to the whole that, again, we go back to being present. Being present fully in the moment. That moment to moment will build the momentum. And as you embrace the presence, the blessings and the gifts unfold in your life. And as simple as that sounds, it's not as easy when you're starting to apply it and it's still new. And when something is new, you have to recognize, whew, give yourself a pat in the back just for the fact that you're showing up and you're doing it. And when you're done, remember, the body has its own reward system. Whenever you do something, you step out of your comfort zone, you make the courage, you come from within and go, okay, I'm gonna do this. And when you do it, you get that flush of those healthy hormones, those chemicals, the oxytocin in your bloodstream. It's like your body rewards you for stepping out of that comfort zone. But it's the key is you doing it. And for every time you do it, you build that courage muscle, right? More and more momentum, moment to moment, you're actually creating the changes that you want to see in your life. But it's mindfulness, it's awareness, it's witnessing, it's observing, it's being present in this moment and recognizing and also celebrating. So celebrate yourself for showing up. Have a happy dance, do a jig, right? It is beautiful outside, but it was chilly in my house very early this morning. And for myself, I can truly attest that when I'm uncomfortable, sometimes I go within. Sometimes I become a little bit more silent. I become a little bit more distant. And that's because I recognize that nobody else can tell me or help me or fix me or show me. I have to do the work. The inside work it's an inside job. Only you can do that. Nobody can go, it's going to be okay. And sometimes that's one of those things that, even because I know I have to go within, I want to help others and I want to reach out and go, is there anything I can do? And I'm not always good with that. I'm still learning and I'm still integrating that into my own life. How can I serve? What's the best way I can show up for another person? The first way is just showing up for myself. Because if I don't show up for myself, I'm going to be of no value to anyone else. And that's a question. You know, it's a question, how much do I value myself? And again, it comes back to the self-love. And if you're not valuing yourself, don't expect anyone else to value you. It starts with self. Everything starts with self, right? Hopefully Monday, my heating will be fixed in the house. The heat strip went. It's all good. So, yeah, you know, routine can be easy. And I was reminded of a story when I was in my program. I had a conference call at 7 this morning. There was a woman on a train when I lived in Naples, Italy, and I was on my way to work. And it was an older lady. She was elderly, and she was retired. And I was overhearing her conversation with the young man about how she was very upset about the changes in the system because it required her to get up and go and do all this stuff and the movement around and having to do things that were outside of her comfort zone, basically, is how it was explained. And that moment, years ago, I was watching, witnessing this woman and realizing, you know, we get so caught up in our routines, we don't want things to be any different. And so when they are different, we get upset at everything outside of us that has caused us to adjust to it, when in reality, it's just part of the flow of life that we're meant to be taken out of our comfort zone in it because we weren't doing it to begin with, which is why it's so important to do something different every day, to take yourself out of your comfort zone. Because the moment you do that, you're actually opening yourself up to the ebb and flow and just, again, it's a beautiful divine dance. So this woman had complained to this young man, and all I could think of was, you know, even as I get older and when I get to the elderly ages, I want to constantly be active. I don't want to be stuck in a routine. Because you see these people who are amazing. They're in their older ages, the wise years, right? These are the wise people applying it and integrating it into their lives. They're not sitting back on a couch or in front of a television being fed what is external to them, which is creating disease within, but they're actually going out. You know, they're the women in their 90s still doing yoga, doing ballroom dancing. You know, they're doing what brings them joy, doing agility training. I've seen some old men doing the agility training, the older gentlemen, and it impresses me because they don't want to stay stuck in a routine. They change it up every single day. Don't you want to be like that? Don't you see people like that and you go, that's what I want to be like when I'm that age? Wow. The wisdom to know that I don't want to be stuck in the same routine every single day, day in, day out, right? Which is what completely shakes up the whole paradigm of, you know, I have a Monday through Friday job and it's 8 to 5 and I take break at this time. Yeah, and things are changing. And I say for the better, because that's the only way we're going to really get to where we want to be if we're not already there, right? Or we want to improve upon where we already are. It's not the when this happens, it's what about what's happening right here, right now. That's again the presence. So I encourage each and every one of you today, hashtag Thirsty Thursday, hashtag tea time, get out of your comfort zone. Go do something, even if it scares you, you'd be rewarded in the end for doing it anyway. And then you're going to probably be like I am every time I think, I really don't want to be bothered by that. Oh, wow, that wasn't as bad as I thought. 9 times out of 10, it's exactly the response I have. That wasn't as bad as I thought. Dang. Okay. Why was it so hard before? It's always what I ask myself later. And that's a great opportunity to journal and write it down. To figure it out. Right? And I've done fasting, and fasting is mentally challenging, especially in the first few days. And then it gets easier. But then it can also create, like, you know, you can, you know, go through a hump even in those 7 days. So yes, and it's also to recognize and discern in your physical body if something you have to learn, because again, the body is going to tell you every time where your mind is at, if it's mental or physical. And so that's the discerning when you go through any type of cleanse or fast, is just please be mindful and aware of your own physical body, because if something is happening, a lot of times you might need to stop it, or you may be able to go longer, right? So, a lot of changes are happening. I'm going through major life changes. I'm, you know, there's a lot I want to share. I don't have the time to do it right this moment, but I love you all so much from my heart, and I'm grateful for all of you that show up. Shift happens, yeah. And you know what? I embrace it all. It's not always easy. I don't always share everything, but I've learned to share. And stay tuned. It's all perfect. It's all divine. I love you. Keep it raw. Stay rad. And I just want to tell you, I made some coffee kombucha the other day, and it is the bomb diggity. If you've never had it, this is a special treat. It's even better than regular coffee. It has a mocha-like flavor, and this particular one is pecan flavor. So, I love you all. Keep it raw, stay rad. Have an amazing Thirsty Thursday. What?